गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज़ वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज़ प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई. प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई में हम मीनिंग डिस्कस करेंगे. देन वी विल सी व्हाट इज़ द प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स. उसके बाद देखेंगे प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विसेज, और उसके बाद हम देखेंगे प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विसेज फॉर द क्रॉस बॉर्डर सप्लाईज. So, to begin with, we have already discussed that India GST framework, जिसमें हमने देखा यदि intra-state movement of goods and services है तो उस पर CGST और SGST applicable होता है, जबकि interstate movement of goods and services के केस में IGST applicable होता है. Depending upon this, the basic principles of place of supply includes: if location of supplier of services and place of supply are in the same state or union territory, उस केस में CGST and SGST as well as UTGST payable applicable होगा. If location of supplier of service and place of supply are in different states, तो IGST applicable होगा. यदि supply of services to or by a SEZ, that is special economic zones, जो कि exports के promotion के लिए बनाए गए हैं, उस purpose के लिए होता है, तब it will be deemed as interstate trade and IGST will be applicable. नेक्स्ट वी आर सीइंग प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स. पहले हम जनरल रूल देखेंगे और उसके बाद एक्सटेंशंस देखेंगे. जनरल रूल की यदि हम बात करें तो इसमें वेयर अ सप्लाई इज़ मेड फ्रॉम अ प्लेस ऑफ बिजनेस फॉर विच द रजिस्ट्रेशन हैज़ बीन ऑब्टेंड, द लोकेशन ऑफ सच प्लेस ऑफ बिजनेस विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई. Where a supply is made from a place other than the place of business for which registration has been obtained, which is a fixed establishment elsewhere, then location of such fixed establishment will be place of supply. Where a supply is made from more than one establishment, whether the place of business or fixed establishment, then the location of establishment most directly concerned with the provision of supply. In absence of such places, the location of the usual place of the residence of supplier will be taken as place of supply. Then we will take the place of supply of goods under section 10 extensions, जिसमें first हमारा आता है where supply involves movement of goods. Then location where movement of goods terminates for delivery will be taken as place of supply. Where goods are delivered to a recipient before or during movement of goods at the direction of third person, then place of principal place of business to of third person will be taken as place of supply. Where supply does not involve movement of goods, then place of location of goods at the time of delivery. Where goods are assembled or installed at site, place of assembly or installation. Where goods are supplied on board a conveyance, then location at which goods taken on board. Then there are residual provision, law made by government on recommendation of GST council. So in this video we have discussed the GST framework, which we have already discussed. Then we have seen the meaning of place of supply, place of supply of goods, meaning thereof, general rule and extensions thereof. Thank you.